In this video, we're going to talk about the respiratory system and the importance of gas exchange in the body. Recall that cellular respiration uses oxygen gas and glucose to produce water, carbon dioxide, and energy in the form of ATP. So this means that our cells need a constant supply of oxygen and must continuously dispose of CO2. The respiratory system facilitates. This gas exchange. So the concept of gas exchange, it really is focused on cellular respiration, where we need oxygen gas, we need to get rid of carbon dioxide. And so this is why we breathe. This is what our respiratory system is for. Now, when we look at the human respiratory system, there are many levels of gas exchange. If we look at the most superficial level, just breathing, we breathe air into our lungs, and then we exhale. We breathe that air out. The air that's coming into our lungs has a higher concentration of oxygen gas, whereas the air that we're breathing out has a higher concentration of carbon dioxide. The amount of nitrogen doesn't really change, and even though that's the major component of our atmosphere, we don't really use nitrogen gas, but we need oxygen, and we need to get rid of carbon dioxide. So why does that happen? Why does the air we breathe out have less oxygen and more carbon dioxide? Well, when we look at what's happening in our lungs, deoxygenated blood is being pumped to the lungs, gas exchange is occurring, that carbon dioxide is leaving by diffusion, oxygen gas is being absorbed into the blood by diffusion, and so oxygenated blood then returns to the heart. But that means that the chemical composition of the air in our lungs, again, will have less oxygen and more CO2. That's why the air that we breathe out is different than the air that we breathe in. But so why was it that we had deoxygenated blood in the first place? Well, this is where we look at what's happening on the cellular level. And again, all of our cells are performing cellular respiration. They're using oxygen gas, producing carbon dioxide. And so the job of our blood is to transport these gases to the areas where they're needed, allow for exchange of those gases, and then take the deoxygenated blood back to the lungs so that the exchange can occur again. So let's look at the structures of our respiratory system. Our lungs are located in the chest cavity. Air moves sequentially through the body, from the mouth and nose to the bronchioles. So as we're breathing in, air comes into our nose or mouth, it moves to our pharynx or our throat, and that leads to our trachea or our windpipe. The trachea branches to the right and left to become bronchi, and then those bronchi will continue to branch into smaller tubes known as the bronchioles. And so the bronchioles are the smallest of the branching tubes within our lungs. So here when we see a diagram of our respiratory system, again, our nose and mouth leading to our pharynx, leading to our trachea, our bronchi, and then to the right and left lung. The diaphragm, which is a sheet of muscle, ends up playing an important role in allowing us to breathe, and we'll discuss the diaphragm in greater detail in just a few moments here. Each of our bronchioles dead ends in a cluster of air sacs called alveoli. The alveoli are these stretchy, elastic pouches or pockets which expand as we inhale and compress as we exhale. Each of these alveoli is surrounded by a capillary network, and so we have deoxygenated arriving via arteries from the heart. Gas exchange occurs. Oxygenated blood is then returning to the heart via the veins. Alveoli carry out the process of gas exchange. in the lungs. Breathing is the alternating process of inhalation and exhalation. So what that means is we breathe in and air moves into our lungs, we breathe out and the air leaves. Now often we almost think of this as somehow pulling air into our lungs, but really what we're doing is by expanding our rib cage and contracting our diaphragm, we're decreasing the pressure within our lungs. And it's actually the air pressure of the atmosphere which forces itself into our lungs at this lower pressure. In the same way, when we want to breathe out, we actually relax our diaphragm, we compress our rib cage, and this increases the air pressure in our lungs, forcing that air out of our lungs, because suddenly the air pressure outside is less than the air pressure inside. Now, an interesting aspect of our respiratory system, we can consciously speed up or slow down our breathing. But we don't always consciously control our breathing. In fact, before I started talking about it, you probably weren't even thinking about breathing at all. Most of the time, automatic control centers in the brain regulate our breathing. The breathing control centers increase or decrease breathing rate in response to CO2 levels in the blood. This is one of those things that your brain is constantly detecting and monitoring, but we don't have conscious awareness of it. Now, if we started to exercise, let's say, and the CO2 level in our blood starts building up, it's going to send signals to increase breathing rate and increase breathing depth. And while we do have some conscious control over our breathing, let's say we were just sprinting as fast as we can for a good 5 or 10 minutes here, it would be very difficult after that extremely strenuous event to say, I'm going to breathe slowly now. It's not until your body is able to bring your carbon dioxide levels back to where they should be that the conscious control of breathing is really returned to us. In our next video, we're going to talk about the role of hemoglobin in oxygen transport. See you then.